on 91.1 The Globe.
Good break, Katie.
Thanks, dude. You too. Good news. Hey, where the heck is Ben?
I don't know. He's supposed to do the sports report in 15 minutes, so he should be in the studio by now.
All right, let's go. Let's go see what's up.
All right.
All right.
What are you doing, Ben?
Ben, what?
What are y'all doing? It's time for yoga. What's wrong with you?
Dude, no, it's like time for sports.
Yeah, it's like...
No.
Soon.
I'm motivated. I'm focused. I'm trying to get ready for sports. Without yoga, there is no sports.
I don't know. Should we join him?
It is National Yoga Day, so I don't see why not.
A few minutes later...
And on the exhale... Squat's a deep, deep squat. Exhale. Now reach for your toes, exhale. Inhale up. Exhale down. Inhale up.
Wait, exhale. Ben, what time? We gotta go on. We gotta go, bro!
You just heard Ruby by Strand of Oaks on 91.1 The Globe. It's 8:47, 65, and foggy. Ben's in the studio now for the sports, all warmed up after doing some yoga.
Yeah, nice and loose. I'm just ready for this report.
Yeah, it's time for yoga day. And so, we were just doing some yoga in the station. Studies have shown that some forms of exercise have actually been better for weight loss, including different types of yoga.
Yeah, because like one thing is like when you hold a position, you're kind of strengthening your body. It's not only stretching. The child's pose, I believe, is where you're on all four. You get the whole basically a high plank. So those are just muscle workouts that can strengthen your hands.
Yeah, this was on Mind Body Green. And they said the more strength and flexibility required for said yoga move, the more that it will help you lose weight.
Yeah, and you won't get injured too. Usually the most flexible athletes are the healthiest.
That's true. You would know. We would know.
Yeah. Hey, I can touch my toes and I haven't been injured in a long time.
Can you do the splits though?
Oh, no. We'd lie on there.